term valuation and what does it mean and the different symbols that we are using to express notations for the dominant range of a particular function. So let's say I have a certain values of x in a graph. Now, you might be thinking it's only for a line, but this graph doesn't necessarily mean it's a line. It could be a parabola like this. Okay, this means that let's say this is negative 2 and this is positive 1. The values of x that hit the graph are from negative 2 to positive 1 except negative 2. Why did I say that? Because this whole means that negative 2 is not part of the solution. So how do we express the domain of this particular function? So first, let's identify the symbols we use. So we have the parentheses. This means that the values of either x or y, because notation could either be domain or range, is not a solution to the problem or solution to the equation. But if you use a bracket, means it's part of the solution of the equation, or it's part of the values of x that will hit your graph. Now, for inequalities, to use bracket means that the values of x could either be equal or greater than that particular value of x, but if you're using parentheses, either less than or greater than. Now, so how do we express this in notation? So the domain of this could either be from negative 2 to positive 1. Notice that I used parentheses for negative 2 and a bracket for positive 1. So we usually order them in the consecutive, the lowest to the left, and the higher to the right. So we can also express this as either intersection or a union, but in this situation, this is an intersection because the values of x are moving towards each other. If the values of x are moving away from each other, then it's a union. So if I'm going to express this as an intersection, okay, negative 2 seems to be going to the right side, so it goes to, let's say, positive infinity, so negative 2 to positive infinity, and I'm using a parenthesis, but positive 1 is moving to the left side, so negative 2 to the right side. So I'm going to make use of a bracket that's 1 to negative infinity. This is another form of notation using intersection or union. In this situation, it is an intersection. You can also express this in inequalities. And as you can see, that the value of x here is greater than 1 or equal to it. And the value of x is less than negative 2 but not equal to it. So therefore, if I'm going to put this together, what I do here is I will first write the greater inequality and then I'm going to flip this. Okay, so instead of using less than, I'm going to make use of greater than negative 2 because the opening is actually 2 negative 2. So this means negative x is less than negative 2 but greater than or equal to 1.